The president has spent the closing weeks of this campaign focused on fear and
unbelievable
and division. What's that done to
Please don't call him the president, because it's so unpresidential. You know, we went from a president that sang Amazing Grace to an occupant in the White House that demonstrates none. I mean, he's just clearly operating with a deficit of empathy, spiritually bankrupt, an inability to see the humanity in his fellow brethren, and the fact that the Republicans' closing argument is one of a hate and fear-mongering and divisive rhetoric is just stunning.
What has that done to the Democratic resistance? I mean, you're like, leading the charge, right? You're watching this unfold.
I think it's emboldened it, because we are at this crossroads, and so as much as we can talk about what we are against and be intentional in the resistance, it's also an opportunity for us to uplift and to affirm what we are for. I feel emboldened, I feel confident, in light of the fact that I think many of the Democratic candidates have run campaigns on a message of hope, of aspiration. So the fact that we're likely walking into a house that is in the Democratic majority will have everything to do with the campaigns like ours that were more about how do we progress and affirming what we are for as a party. So I really do see this is a fight for the soul of the Democratic Party and the future of our democracy.